week out, October 22nd. I was traveling through my boyhood haunts in Oakville the other day, and I was remarking to a friend, I said, man, this town seems to have lost its mojo. What the dickens is going on? And he said, well, what you want to do is talk to Julia Hanna, who was running for mayor of Oakville because she was a president of the local chamber of commerce, a successful businesswoman and restaurateur for over 35 years, and she would set things right if she were elected. And I thought, well, then I'll probably give her a call and see what she has on plan should she be successful against the incumbent, Rob Burton, who's been there, I think, a dozen years or so. So Julia Hanna, candidate for mayor of Oakville, is joining the open show at Global News Radio 640 Toronto. Julia, how are you doing this afternoon?
So wonderful to talk to you. And I, you know what they say about coming, be careful who you come after, and coming after the naked Shark Tank guy. thanks a lot.
Well, you know, if it comes to be a tourist attraction, Oakville could
That's
do
right.
worse than put a big tank in the middle of town square there and have naked people.
There we go. Thanks for that one, John. Thanks.
Well, that's all right. You know, we've got to work in collusion here to try to find something to save Oakville from itself. Because, you know, as a friend was remarking, and we were having this discussion, I remember very well the Lakeshore was a vibrant hub of activity and so on and so forth. It seems like it's lost its luster and its vitality. Broughty Harbor, same idea. These things were crown jewels along the waterfront. What gives? What's happened, Julia, to Oakville?
Well, thank you for bringing that up, because really they were crown jewels, and one of the most distressing bits of information I received just the other day is that some of the councillors in Oakville that are running and some of the nominees are saying, look at downtown Oakville as the example of what you don't want to do. And, you know, and what I'm hearing all the time is people saying, what's happened? What's happened? I mean, I had a business in downtown Oakville that just for 35 years, John. So what's happening? It's like anything else. When something is going well, that's when you have to work the hardest to maintain it. That's when you have to keep reinventing yourself. It's like a good marriage, a good relationship, anything. And we haven't done that. We have ignored it. And as the merchants were screaming and begging, please pay attention. We need help. They're being ignored. And the end result of that is we have a downtown that isn't the jewel that it once was.
Wow. So how would you revitalize it and reclaim it? What needs to be done? I'm told Halton's projected to be the fastest growing census division in Ontario with a growth of 56% up until 2041. It's going to be the fastest place in all of Ontario. That's Halton Region. So, I mean, if you're anticipating big growth, I would think you'd want things in place to make sure that this is organized and it really accrues to the benefit of the citizens.
Well, absolutely. And think about it. How many communities could say that they have distinct communities within their community? Look at, we have Kerr Street, which is a funky artistic area. We have the wonderful mellow Brawny with that beautiful harbor. And we have this funky, exciting downtown Oakville. That's what we had. And we need to get it back. And how are we going to do that? You have to, first of all, make it a priority. You have to decide that this is important. It's like everything else. Once it's gone, we all know how hard it is to get it back. So we have to first acknowledge that we need help, and the town needs to help these areas. And how are they going to do that? We need to decide that it's important. We need to invest in economic development to help businesses set up, remove the red tape, induce them to come and set up their businesses. We need a visitor retention plan. Do you know that we have no visitor retention plan? So how can we expect that three of these communities can survive, John, without visitors coming to visit us? We need them here.
Again, Julia Hanna's with us. Julia's a candidate for mayor of Oakville. You know, when I lived there, I remember the marinas being sort of hubs of activity as well in Bronte and at the mouth of the 16-mile creek. But, you know, it seems to me like, if I'm reading it right here, the marina business is something the city's involved in, and you think it ought not to be. Why not?
I think that the city should be involved with running the town. Our town needs to run the town. And if I'm looking at that we are not running our town as effectively as we need to when we look at these three particular areas, and especially the downtown, then that tells me we need to focus on what we should be doing, which is taking care of our town. And, you know, when we're in businesses, we do not belong in other people's businesses. We need to support our businesses in Oakville. We need to help them. We need to collaborate with them. But our job is to run the town. That's our job.
Well, my understanding as well is since 2008, property taxes have cumulatively increased 64%.
Yes.
And town spending is double. So, I mean, this is really, that would deter people from wanting to live there. And I guess, even though it is a fancy part of the province, and there are some high, I remember back in the day, it was the highest by per capita income place in all of Canada, wasn't it?
Well, it was. I don't know what our stats are on that, but I think that, you know, we have been voted the number one town to live in by Money Sense Magazine, but those are wonderful accolades, and gosh, we are thrilled to receive them. But that doesn't mean we can't have a sleight of hand. And what we have happening right now is sleight of hand. Pay attention over here. Look at what's happening here, but don't look at what's going on over here. And what we're saying is we have to pay attention to these communities. You know, John, I survived in the restaurant business for 35 years. You know why? Because I get that we're only as good as our last meal.
Well,
doesn't matter what I did 2 years ago. And how have you survived all these years? And being a leader in what you do.
Well, listen, Julia, there's something else I was wondering about, a story that came to my attention where somebody on town council has a criminal record, and I guess. What's the story behind that?
Well, that was a tough one because we've known about that, and we just, you know, we want to make sure that, you know, that this campaign is about positive, and we want to get people feeling like they're empowered. But you cannot not deal with the issue that you have a mayor who has kept on council for a year, a counselor that was charged, then pleaded guilty to criminal harassment, and didn't even think it was necessary to tell his counsel, and in fact endorsed them on a mayor letterhead. Basically saying, if this man cannot run in the next election, it will impact me. Well, this is not about you. This is about the people who live in this community. And we need to believe that you're going to make the best decisions for us. And not telling anyone about this and not making the right decision by saying, okay, you pled guilty, but now you are found guilty. Now it's time to move on.
Wow,
right?
So integrity's become an issue in this campaign as well.
Absolutely.
Julia, let me ask you a couple of quick questions here as well, because, you know, it's obviously inevitable that these marijuana dispensaries are going to be located in some communities and others not. We heard from Mayor Scarpitti in Markham earlier today. He was saying that they won't be any in his community. What if you're elected mayor of Oakville? Would you allow for marijuana dispensaries?
Here's what I know. It is the law, right? And when I have young people telling me everywhere I go, they say to me that it was easier for them to buy marijuana on the street than it was to buy alcohol or cigarettes. Then I think legislating it and controlling it is the best way to go. But the secret is it has to be done well. And we need to really work hard to ensure that everyone is protected in the community. But by pretending and that this won't go underground, if you ban it in your community, it's just naive. It's not the truth.
All right. Well, yeah, I'd ask Scarpitti about that as well, because I think it will actually lead to a black market. Finally, I got to ask, because I know Glen Abbey's been another big story there in Oakville, and this is the golf course that is owned by Club Link, and they want to do a massive development there and put in all kinds of condos and freehold homes and towers and so on and so forth. So what's your take on the status of Glen Abbey? How do you see this proceeding?
Well, pretty amazing how many issues we do have in this sort of our little town, and that's why this election is such an important one. Glen Abbey, if Glen Abbey were to leave, we would never be able to get it back. And all I'm proposing is, right now, we're fighting this as a heritage designation, which is wonderful, and we need to stay the course because we've spent $5.5 million in legal fees alone. We may be spending another 5 and 10. But all I'm saying and proposing is, what if the courts don't move in your favor? Then what? What's your backup plan? What's the alternative? And our alternative is, why not? Let's talk about how Glen Abbey can serve all the residents of Oakville. Remember, John, most people tell me they've never walked through those gates. And if this legal battle fails, the option to look at it as a central park for all of Oakville is something worth pursuing.
Wow. So would you buy it from ClubLink then?
Well, see, the thing is, that's what we're, right now we have, for example, we do know that you can have, we can put a hotel there. It's been designated to put a 150-room hotel there. And I think that this is something to pursue, talking to all the levels of government, including federal, provincial, and municipal, and benefactors. What do we know about Oakville? Oakville, you talked about the economy. We have a lot of people in Oakville that do a lot of good things, and I can imagine that we will have benefactors that would want to talk about this.
Well,
so they can, right?
Yeah, well, it's going to be an interesting one. I guess you're ramping up and really excited about next Monday then.
Well, I have to tell you, I'm glad that this is a radio interview and that you don't have to see my face right now. I got to be honest with you.
Why is that? Why is it?
It's exhausting, but it is. We are running on adrenaline. We have momentum. I have great news I got today. We crashed our website.
That's good news, is it?
Okay. We crashed our website, so that means people are interested in. And I appreciate you talking to us, and I hope to celebrate with you after the 22nd, John.
Well, all right. Hope you're celebrating as well. Maybe we'll bring along the Naked Shark Tank guy.
I was going to say, maybe that's again. We'll talk more about that in the town square. You know, you never know.
Okay. Well, there you go. It would be a tourist attraction for sure. Julia, good to make your acquaintance, and good luck next Monday.
Right back at you, John. It was an absolute pleasure. And we'll talk to you after.
All right. Julia Hanna there is running for mayor of Oakville. And,